This is Sway. Sway.
Sway.
Sway.
In the morning.
In the morning.
In the morning.
I'll shake this line.
Wake your punk ass up. That crust touch.
Got a chance. Jeff Gordon kind of piqued my interest in NASCAR. A while back, I don't know what it was about Jeff Gordon. I ended up getting a jersey with his number on it, all kinds of stuff, and so much so that I went to the Talladega 500 a couple years back, and it was the most culture shocking experience I had up until that point, because it's a whole sector of our country that I've never been exposed to. I've only read about, and seen in movies. I thought it was a myth, but it was like 75,000 or no more than that, right?
Yeah, there's probably around 100,000.
100,000 people in the stands.
Wow.
In the stands, not watching on TV. Those are like MTV2 numbers right there. And a lot of Confederate flags. I had to get used to that, Kev. Did you have to get used to that? You were born and raised in Cali.
Look, I was born and raised in California, so I'm like you. When I came to the Southeast, things were different than what they were in California. So when I was growing up, it was, there wasn't a lot of racing in California either.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
I grew up in a town, Bakersfield, California, that I was fortunate to have a asphalt track, a dirt track, a go-kart track, a drag strip.
Mm-hmm.
But NASCAR racing was really where it was at as far as the racing world went, and it was primarily in the Southeast at that particular time. But when Jeff Gordon came in, he kind of broke down all those barriers and helped change the sport into what it is today. And there's more drivers from California now than there are from any other state.
Yeah. So that Confederate flag, though, how did you get? Here's the most interesting thing, because what you don't know, I was ignorant to a whole lot of things, okay? Only what I knew from history. So I walk in the stands, and a big, brolic guy, 6'2", looked like he just killed a hog with his hands and ate it for breakfast, would come up to me with a Confederate flag on his shirt with cut-off sleeves, and fucking hug me.
Yeah.
Like, Sway, I was watching you on MTV and all this stuff. And I'm like, yo, is this dude about to kidnap me? But it was nothing but love.
No.
The environment is interesting. Like, you wouldn't know until you go experience it, right?
Right. Yeah, and I think when you look at the Confederate flag and everything that's happened with it, and being from California, you're like, I didn't know anything existed but an American flag.
Right.
Yeah.
And when you look at society in general today, and whether it's a black, white, gay, and I look at it for myself, and I'm like, how have we not just moved completely away from this? Because I didn't even realize that the world was even still in this, in this
mindset.
Thought process of where we are today. So, I think when you go to the races, I don't know that, half of them are just wearing the t-shirts because it was across the street, and that's what they bought. But that's really the environment. It's a culture for everybody, and I think that there's a lot of myths of how it works and how things are, but it's really not like that when you're involved in it. You can't experience a NASCAR race on TV and experience what it's like until you actually go and see and feel the environment and experience those things for yourself. So it's definitely a lot different than what most people see from the outside looking.